up for a congregation. I don't know of any, put their congregation in better, no worse than the United States. Thank the Lord. So, I'm so happy to see every one of you, and I'm glad you got to see me. One more year, one more day, you bless me here. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, but I think.
Now, is it possible?
Yes.
That all of that congregation can be saved? Yes, it is. It is His will that all of you would be saved. Yes, it is. Well, what could be the trouble that you wouldn't get over? You're the trouble. Give yourself to the Lord, and you can go. We're getting ready to go and get started in the service, and I want all of you to feel free. Be happy to come here, and let's get started in the sanctuary. I know there's a lot of sanctuary here tonight. Well, we got a group of singers that we'll thank a couple and let them have it. So we're glad to have you. Come on. If you don't come up here and sing, I'll let you go later.
Thank you.
Gibbs, I guess.
Brother Gibbs, no.
Brother Jess, ask your blessing. Everybody bow.
Dear kind and heavenly Father, God, tender mercy, it's once more that you bless together, together, this little building here beside the road. We pray this evening, dear Lord, that everyone come with a song upon our heart.
Yeah.
Prayer up in their mind, dear Lord, if we may be able to render service unto you, that you be well pleased with. We pray, dear heavenly Father, for all the many blessings that you bestowed upon us as we trod here upon your footstool. Now would you be with us, Lord, and let us be mindful of those, dear Lord, upon the outside, in our safety, this may be the very hour that would change their minds, dear Lord, and come to you before it's too late. For all these favors and blessings we ask in Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Amen.
Amen.
190.
190.
This is a nice one, a close group, you know.
Glad you're able to be with us.
If I didn't have word of my heart to say, I would have been here.
There's a city of light where there comes.
tonight. I'm glad that they can make it. I wanted to feel right at home. This time, I'm going to sing some songs.
I tell Brother Bowler a minute ago, that kind of singing, I'm glad I got two ears. Singing in stereo. You don't hear that kind of singing anymore. I just praise the Lord tonight that I was here to hear that. Pray for us, we've all been, I'm not making excuses, but Brother Bowler been sick all week. I don't know what, I guess I'm getting the same thing. But you all pray for us. We read in the Bible of a man named Paul, Peter and John, good disciples. Always see their story in the holy pages, faithful and true to the endless ages. I want to have a testimony too, like Moses and Daniel and Elijah do. I want to stay the course like the men of old. When the story of my life is told, when the story of my life is told, when the past and the future unfold, when the Lord called me home and the judgment comes, will it welcome me? Will I hear well done? When the story of my life is told, will it tell about a witness so bold? Will it say I kept the faith until my dying day? When the story of my life is told.
Hey, my way, Jesus will hear every time I pray. He'll pick me up and make me that much stronger. Help me walk just a little bit longer.
I want to live a life to testify. Whatever I need, Jesus will supply. I want a life to show that I met my goal. When the story of my life is told, when the story of my life is told, when the past and the future unfold, when the Lord called me home and the judgment come, will he welcome me? Will I hear well done? When the story of my life is told, will it tell about a witness so bold? Will it say I kept the faith until my dying day? When the story of my life is told, when the story of my life is told, when the past and the future unfold, when the Lord called me home and the judgment come, will he welcome me? Will I hear well done? When the story of my life is told, will it tell about a witness so bold? Will it say I kept the faith until my dying day? When the story of my life is told.
Yeah.
He lives in the heart.
stand. God lives in a house not made with hands. God lives in a house not made with hands. He lives in the heart of fallen man. The God of the temple in Jerusalem lives in a house not made with hands. God lives in a house not made with hands.
Hallelujah.
He lives in the heart of fallen man. The God of the temple in Jerusalem lives in a house not made with hands.
Amen.
Amen.
All right.
There is not a mother, sister, friend, or brother loved the way that Jesus can. He proved his love for me when he died on Calvary. He gave his life for fallen man.
His love
is a boundless love, and it reaches down and touches me.
Bible area, people die.
Yeah.
Heads cut off. They're getting froze to death.
Yeah.
All because of the name of Jesus.
Yeah, yes.
And we don't see it, but we hear about it a little.
Yeah, we do.
We don't hear about it, they don't tell us, but.
They don't want to.
They don't want to know, they don't want us to know it. But I tell you what, the name of Jesus, there's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved.
Amen.
Before we sing another one, there's a little chorus I want to sing. And it's just a chorus. And I want you to sing it with us, if you know it. I think everybody does. Jesus. 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 There's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus, like the fragrance after the rain.
Praise the Lord.
Savior,
sing it, come on.
Jesus.
is the bomb that can mend broken hearts with one sharp end. A hand that hung,
yes,
this whole world is
yes, Lord, he's the Lord.
Is the hand that was scarred just to give me grace,
yes,
and to thank a hand that can hold a star, yet is small enough to mend one broken heart.
And when I can't stand, I have to leave. And when I can't see, I must be.
You know, I've been praying all day that the Lord would clear my voice up so I could sing tonight. And up to now, he has.
Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord.
And I'll go around. I'm trusting.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
I trust the Lord.
Yeah, man.
I believe the Lord. And that's what he wants us to do. He wants us to believe us when he tells us something. He wants us to believe it. And I believe his word. Get in the right keys. Up ahead is the shoreline on the mighty Red Sea. There's no way to cross it.
Pray for me and my beloved ones.
Brother Ray been going in the hospital in the morning for procedure, y'all keep Brother Ray in.
Yeah.
Let's thank him for the good time and life.
You know, Christian people need prayer. We've been praying for a long time. And hopefully, and I'm not losing my mind, I'll continue to pray until I get out of here. I need his strength, I need his guidance, I need his comfort. So we all need prayer, whether we're saved or unsaved. Let us remember, as Brother Bruce said, let us remember the ones that's still on the outside. We'd love to see them get in the fold of God. We'd love to see them become a child of God. And you can, whenever you give them your whole heart, give them your life. Say, if you're in my house, I want to serve the Lord the rest of my life. He'll come in. He said, he promised. He said, I and my Father will come in and take up our abode. So he'll sup with you, you can sup with him. That's what's going on here tonight. That's what's going on here tonight. That's what's been going on down through this week. We've been supping with each other. Me and the Lord. And you and the Lord. So let's thank him, let's praise him that we have that opportunity. Anyone else?
We remember all the little children in Mr. Trees,
shooting and killing, the drugs is taking over the world, seems like. Getting more evil, more wickeder all the time. So let's remember each other. No one else? If not, we're going to look to the Lord. I'd like to ask Brother John, if he would, to come up and lead this prayer. Glad you're able to be with us.
We ask you, Lord, most sweet things. Amen.
Amen.
I want to thank you all for coming. All thanks for the receipt you ran through. There are a lot of you that achieved this, come to visit with us, and work with us, fellowship with us. The different churches, different brands, different titles, different signs over the door. And I'm just thankful that you're here. And if you're a Christian, you're my brother and my sister.
Yeah, amen.
And I ain't got nothing above you, and you ain't got nothing above me. We're all one. We're all made out of that dust out there that we walk on. God bless it, and open it, and fashion it. Breathe into the breath of life, and here we are. We ain't got nothing to boast of, only in him. Even one made us, after a while, that breath of leave it, and go right back to what was, and sorry. So where's boasting at?
It's all in Jesus. Bring it in.
Blessing you.
Woo, hallelujah.
My cup is running over.
No, I'm his too.
It's because I feel it. Believe in it, it's here. So, lots of thoughts have run through our minds today. Things that we thought we'd turn to and read, and now it seems like all that's gone. And we're wondering, Lord, we'll just stand there and we'll dress like you did. About your singing, we'll do the same thing. If we don't come along our way and help us here in a minute, we'll help us and some of these other brothers. But I'm thankful to be a child of God with everything that there is. And God is still in the saving business. And he'll save our friends that are here tonight. It's not saved. He'll save you tonight. You'll have to wait tomorrow. And he'll save you tonight. If you'll do your part, he'll do his part. I don't know, there seems to be a song laid on our mind, but I think the same after listening to these brothers from Old Parent Same Squirty. We thank you all for coming every year.
Yes.
I said, oh, where? I never shouted or nothing while you sung, but I said, oh, where? My tears were flowing. Make me feel good. That we're singing about the one I love and the one that loves me. Nobody else has ever loved me like he has. No one. If anybody ever does, it would be by him that they do it.
That's right.
My friend, that's the only way that one human can love another like he does, is to do it with his prayer. And it's possible. It's possible. I'm waiting in the water, Lord, just trying to get home. Sometimes the waves dash so high, I think that I'm done. But when I think I'm about to sink, I hold my hand up high, and that great big hand of God comes down and takes a hold of mine. When Moses and all Israel fled from Pharaoh and his men, it looked as if they all would die, and fear fell on them. My God said to Moses, stretch your hand out o'er the sea, and he rolled back the waves for him, just like he does for me. I'm waiting in deep water, Lord, just trying to get home. Sometimes the waves dash so high, I think that I'm gone. But when I think I'm about to sink, I hold my hand up high, and
and that great big hand of God comes down and takes a hold of him. When Peter went to meet the Lord, just walking on the sea, he looked around and saw the waves, and he began to sing. My Lord heard his crying, "Oh Lord, please help me." And he reached down his hand for him, just like he does for me. I'm waiting in the water, Lord, just trying to get home. Sometimes the wave that's so high, I think that I'm done. When I think I'm about to sink, I hold my hand up high, and that great big hand of God comes down and takes a hold of me. Friends, it's God's will that none would perish, but that all would come to Him and have life. And God has fixed it that everybody can. There's really no reason that all of us can't go to heaven. I'd like for you to just kind of ask yourself, as you sit there quietly, I'd like for you to just kind of ask yourself, do you feel Him in there? You hear them sing that song? That he don't dwell in houses or temples no more.
No.
The Apostle Paul made it plain when he was out on Mars Hill. He said, God dwelleth not in houses made with man's hands and all these things. Yeah. He was looking at them big temples. That God has made everything. He ain't got no need to be glamorized with big buildings and marble posts and everything. He's not in that stuff, my friend, but he took all of that out of the way. And now he's fixed it. Come down inside of me.
Amen.
I want you to ask yourself, do you know if he's in there or not?
You know.
I know we have brethren that don't think we can know. My friend, but I read a day or two in the New Testament over and over and over that we could know. And we can know. And we do know. And we should know. Now what I'd like for you to do, if you don't feel him in there, I'd like for you to just look your life over and ask yourself, why don't you feel him in there? Has he been in there before? Did he used to be there? My friends, have you never had him in there? I don't know. I can't look in the heart. I'm not one of the apostles. Well, bless God, they can look right down inside. Not a man or woman's what they had inside. My friends, and tonight, there's no way on earth that I can look in there. But I can tell you that you can examine yourself and see if you've got him in there or not. And if you've got him in there, you'll surely know it. Because never has anybody ever spoke to me the way he did after that he's come inside. My friend, listen. When they heard Jesus speak, they went and told the men that sent them after him. They said, why didn't you bring him to us? And they said, never has a man spake like this man spake. Listen tonight. He will speak to you somewhere, sometime. He'll speak to you. I don't know when it'll be. Maybe you already have. But he will speak to you sometime in your life. Like we read the other night. If he was crucified, he said, I will draw all men unto me. That's a precious promise tonight. That he will draw all men to me. Would you all pray for me for a few minutes? Because I need his help tonight. There's nobody nowhere that ever preached a gospel sermon without the Lord. They listen to him. And if he thinks he's big enough to do it on his own, I don't even want to hear him, my friend. And if he thinks he knows it all, I don't want to hear him anymore, because he don't know nothing as he ought to know. I'd like to tell you that everything that I've amounted to, it's by the grace of God. I was going nowhere, real fast, getting worse off all the time, until I felt him, and I heard him, and I had him reach out his hand for old Tom. Listen, my friend, Jesus fixed this first, and he fixed it on purpose. There's no accident in the Word of God. There's no coincidence in that Bible. It was all on purpose, this plan of salvation. Listen, he's been calling me for a long time in different ways. My friend, back in the old days, he spoke to our Father by the mouth of the prophets. My friend, and they preached and they prophesied and they pointed to the time that a better day was a coming. They had a covenant. They all had a covenant. Adam had one. Moses had one. Abraham had one. Though, as you can see it in the sky through a big rain shower, you can see the bow in the cloud. Every promise that God has ever made, he'll keep it, my friend. So it would be of you and I to find out what promises is in that favor. Listen, he set this up line upon line, precept upon precept. It started out in the Garden of Eden, and he began to mold it, my friend. And God has always worked in the affairs and in the kingdom of men here. Bless his name. He came to Abraham one time, and he said, Abraham, leave your people, and I'll take you where you don't even know where you're going. How'd you like to just up and pack your bags and go with that? Leave your family, not know where you're going. He sure did it, and he followed the voice of the Lord. And tonight, if he bids you to get up and follow him and leave everything, you'd be best to follow that voice. It'll never lead you in the wrong way. It'll lead you beside still water, my friend. It'll lead you where the pasture is a lot greener, better feeding. It'll lead you to the shelter of his fold. Yes, he'll lead you to the well of salvation, and they'll spring up inside of you unto everlasting life tonight. Oh, bless God tonight. He's so good, and his word is forever settled in heaven. He sets up thine on the circle of the earth, and every word, every jot, every tittle of his word, it'll come to pass. He said he'd save them that comes to him, and he said he would damn those in a lake of fire that resist him and turn him away. Where are you at tonight? Where do you stand in all this? Bless your heart, my friend. You can have the same God living inside of you that the rest of us have. It don't matter what your name is, where you've been, or what you've done. He'll save you tonight, and he'll wash you and sanctify you and justify you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And there's nobody else nowhere can do that. Bless his name. His name is exalted. His name is Jehovah. He will provide everything that we have the need of. He's got it. His storehouse, it's full and running over. And he's the one to give it to you if you'll meet his turn tonight. Listen, Abraham, you go, leave your people. And he up and left all of his kingdom, went to a strange land. And he asked him, God told him, listen, Abraham, you see this land? I'm going to give it to you and to your descendants through all generations. And Abraham went on for a little while, and then he call on God. And he began to ask him, I said, Lord, you promised me this, and I ain't even got a child. Here I am, 90 years old. I ain't got a child. I'm past the age of having one. My friend, listen, you may think things is hopeless with you. Life is already passed you by. That's the time to be saved and get your heart right. It's already gone. But God can still work it out if you'll come to him. He's got a way of redeeming the time. He can restore to you the years that the locust is in. Yes, my friend, he can take your heart that's barren and dry, and he can make it moist and make it grow. Yes, our God is able with just his voice. When he speaks, it'll thunder from heaven. My friend, the Bible said that from his mouth no lightning and thundering, just a little whisper, and it can shake the earth. My friend, you think he can't come in your heart and take that black, stony thing and make it new? Yes, he can. Yes, he will. Yes, he wants to. Tonight, he's your Savior. He's your Creator. He's the one that gives you life and breath tonight. And you owe him everything you got. Won't you sell out to the devil and take your father by the hand? Let him lead you where you need to go tonight. My friend, listen, if you're not with him, you're dead tonight. If you're not with him, you're lost out in a valley, a wilderness, a desolate place. My friend, if you're not with him, you're living in the land of deceit, my friend, and you're deceived by the accuser, of the brother, the old devil. You're right where he wants you to be. But listen, you must get up and move if you want to be saved. You can't sit and do nothing. You've got to follow the voice of the Lord. Brother, now listen, you must have prayed, because I feel like I could go on for 2 hours now. Yeah, my God tonight, how great thou art. Listen, Abraham, I'm going to show you. I'll do what I said. Come out here. Brought him out. He said, I want you to look up. Count the stars in the sky. If you can count them, that's what I'm going to do for you and for your descendants. Brother, let me ask you, reckon it was daytime or reckon it was nighttime when he took him out? I say it was nighttime. My friend, listen, you may be in darkness, but if you look up, God will begin to show you the lights of heaven, and they will illuminate but down on the inside, and they'll light your path where you need to take the next step. If you can't see where you're going, see it out to him. That won't matter to start with. If he shows you this step right here, take that one. If you don't know where it's at out there, but he lights this, take another, and he'll just keep lighting it up. And after a while, bless your heart, you'll be right where he wants you, and he'll light it all up. My friend, it ain't a feeling like it in this world. But I have the Lord to light you up on the inside and show you clearly what's at stake. My friend, listen, Abraham, he said, I will multiply you and bless you. And he went ahead a little further, and he said, through you and your seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. Yeah, oh sinner friend, I know this may be deeper than what you may get out of it, but just hold on a little while. I want to show you but God's been at work for a long time, and it was for your benefit and for mine. And all I can do tonight, I can't find the word to thank him enough, but just say thank you, God, for all that you've done, not only for me, but for the whole human family, for my family that's on drugs, for my family that's lost and undone, for my family that's locked up in the prison cell. We all got them, but there's a God that can hear you if you're down in a dungeon or in a cave somewhere, my friend, in the darkest hour, my friend, down in the lowest valley, in the darkest pit, sin may have you wrapped up and bound up, and have you bound down, and you feel like you've got no place to turn to. It may feel like he's got such a hold in your life that you can't get up, but I'll tell you what, that can unlock it all and raise you up. They'll take you by the hand, bless God, and do for you what nobody else is able to do. He said, Abraham, he said, I want you to go now. I want you to take some young heifers and some more animals and doves and stuff, and I want you to make a sacrifice. And Abraham took them. He sliced the heifers in half and some of the other things. He cut in two and he put all your offering now. My friend, I'm liking what I'm seeing. Yes, sir. This son, this world hates you. This world is your enemy. My friend, this world ain't got nothing for you but death and darkness. But Jesus is light. Jesus is the way. Jesus is life. And if you take hold of him, you'll have to stand up against the devil and this darkness and this world. You'll have to die to this world and its play pretties. You'll have to quit the sin business. And you too will have to make a heart sacrifice in order to please God. You can't come to God without faith, my friends. And when you get faith in him, you'll give up everything that they are in this world to be called a child of the Most High God. Oh, yes, my friends. Song it said, I'd rather be an old time Christian than anything I know. Brother Tony, I've heard some of our crowd and visitors say we ain't here preaching like that in 20 years. I don't know about you, but that just blesses my heart to know we got the old time gospel that sets men and women free. We're not here to play games and hopscotch around. God's looking down at you. He knows if there's an empty place in your heart. He knows what you stand in need of before you ever asked him. And he's just a standing there with outstretched arms, giving you the blessing, the invitation that's above every other one in this world. And that invitation is to come. If you're brokenhearted, come anyway. If your home is busted up, come anyway. If you've been mistreated and abused, come anyway. God's got a way of taking you in his arms and binding it all up and healing every bit of it and setting you at liberty. Bless your heart. They said, Abraham, make that sacrifice. And he cut those meat up and he laid it on the altar. And he told him, after a while, it must have been daytime then, because it was nighttime when he told him to number the stars. And he said, after a while, the birds started coming down, trying to get the sacrifice. And Abraham had to shoot them back. Tonight, and through this revival, every time that God and you have gained a little ground together, the evil one has been present in you, right there, trying to come down, snatch it all away. You, it's up to you. God didn't do it for Abraham. Abraham had to do it for himself, and he had to shoot back of the crows and the buzzards that are flying everywhere in every direction. I've never seen so many anti-Christian forces of flying around making battle against the church of Jesus Christ as I do today. But bless his name. In his name, you can do what you need to serve him. Abraham, shoot him away. And after a while, the Bible said that he fell in. I'm getting in too deep, boys. But I love it. Oh, yes, I'm feeling good now. And he said, there's a great darkness come over Abraham. And there was a horror inside. My friends, tonight, I love it. If darkness would come over you in a way that you could feel it, and open your eyes and see where you're at, and see how scary that it is to be in the claws of old Lucifer. And he's got you right there. He pulls you right to him. And as long as you go on in this world, he's happy about it. You're not paying no attention. You're drowning in darkness. Your heart has been hardened. You're being won over by the slickest creature that ever was made. My friends, I'm begging you tonight, open your eyes and let God light your way. And if you will, you'll begin to feel that love that they sung about. And when you feel that and you start loving him back, you'll feel the power start working in your life. Bless God. That's the best thing you'll ever feel. Come in contact with him. My friend, it'll take care of the rest. And you'll do your part. And after a while, Abraham was really scared. And I'm glad he was. I'm glad I got scared. I hope you get scared. My friends. And he said, Abraham, when he woke him up, he had saw a smoking furnace and a burning lamp. And God told him, said, Abraham, your children, you may be 90, but I'm going to work a miracle with you. He said, your children will multiply, and they'll go into a strange land, and they'll be servants there, and they'll be maltreated for 400 years, and then I'll burn them out. They've got some hard times to go through, but after a while, that burning land will light them out there, and that's where the sea had to stood still that she sung about. God will fulfill his promise just like he did to them. 400 years later, Moses brought them out across the Red Sea on dry ground. Listen, my friend, he fulfilled it and he brought them out there. And today, we're living in a new time, the best of times. And God, after that, he had spoke by the mouth of the prophets. My friend, the Bible said, in these last days, he's spoken unto us by his Son, Jesus Christ. I ain't looking for nobody else. I don't need a pope. I don't need nothing else. Give me Jesus like they sung. Jesus, my friend, he's got the greatest name. That means Joshua in the Old Testament. The same name. What does it mean? The Lord, the God Almighty, is salvation. And he will save to the uttermost. And at just the right time, he sent his Son into the world. And after 30 years, he began to preach. But God endowed him and put the unction of the Holy Ghost on him. And tonight, after that, he's raised from the dead. There's something going on here. When the gospel is preached and the story about Jesus, it's going to do something inside of you. It'll be up to you to follow.
Amen.
I want to go on.
We've been hearing what God is able to do for us. What God has already done for us. All about some of His promises that He has in store. You can't go wrong.
No.
If we trust in God's promises. The love of God. One of the writers said, "Behold, what manner of love hath the Father bestowed upon us, that we should be called His sons of God." There's that love. You can't get away from that love. You can't get away from that love. And we've been preaching this week, all of us, trying to get people to have faith. To
believe
in God and in the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you'll believe, that's what Jesus said, I mentioned last night, if you would only believe. And if you have faith in it, I thought sitting on the seat about faith. You can't make it without faith. And James, he kind of described here in the little book of James how important that faith is. And he described how important that works is with faith. I could have sat back there and had faith all my life and died in my sins if I hadn't put a little bit of work in it. If I hadn't moved out and put works with my faith. But faith, as we said last night, we're justified by faith. The just shall live by faith. That's the way we're living tonight, is by faith. Not by sight, but by faith. And in the little book of James here, in the second chapter, in the 14th verse, it says, "What doeth it profit, my brethren, though a man say he has faith, and hath not works?"
Amen.
Can faith save him? If a brother or sister be naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you say unto them, "Depart in peace, be ye warmed and filled," notwithstanding ye give them not those things which are needful to the body, what doth it profit? Yeah, I can just tell people, just go away and be warm and filled, not give them what he's saying to need. That ain't very good works, is it? Even so, faith, if it has not works, it's dead. Faith is dead being alone. I'm just going to take my time. I want people to understand this. Even so, faith, if it has not works, is dead, being alone. Yea, a man may say, "Thou hast faith, and I have works." He says, "Show me thy faith without works, and I will show thee my faith by my works." What a difference, ain't it? "Thou believest that there is one God, thou doest well. The devils believed, the devils also believed and trembled. But wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead?" Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he had offered Isaac his son upon the altar? Seest thou how faith wrought with his works, and thy works was made perfect? And the scripture was fulfilled which saith, Abraham believed God, and it was imputed unto him for righteousness. And he was called a friend of God. He believed God. He had faith in him. When he took his son out there and offered him, he had all the faith in God that he would, him and the lad would go out and they would return. He had faith in that. He believed God. Well, Tony, that's the same way it is with us today and you. If we believe God and have faith in what God has promised us, we'll want to do what he has asked us to do, and we'll go all the way with our works, keeping the faith. It's like the Apostle Paul, when he come down time for him to leave out of this world, he said, the time of my departure is at hand. I have far good fight. There's works in that, but Paul had a lot of works in that.
Yes, sir.
There's a lot of works in fighting the good fight of faith.
Amen.
There's a lot of works for Christian men and women to be doing after we become a child of God. You get enough faith and hear the gospel and have enough faith to call out on the Lord to save you from your sins and put works with it, go down here and be buried with Christ in baptism, then he'll add you to the church, then you can put works with your faith and work out your salvation with fear and trembling before God. There's work to do after you become a child of God. Can't work your way in before you get there.
Amen.
You get in the vineyard, he said, go into my vineyard and labor, and whatsoever's right, I'll pay you. So put a little bit of faith, put a little bit of works with your faith, and move out on that and obey God. Trusting that God will give to you what he has promised you. What has he promised us? He's promised me, just like the Apostle Paul, the same thing. Paul said, the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. And I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me, and not for me only, Paul said, but to all that will love and look for a second appearing. Do you want a crown? Do you want a crown of life? Do you want a life eternal when this life here is over? Or do you want eternal punishment and damnation for eternity? That's a choice that we must make here in this life.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Fear is the beginning of wisdom. Turning down evil is getting understanding. So listen tonight, my friends, if we'll fear God and obey him, there is a crown that's laid up for us. And bless God, listen, I, with all the faith that I've got tonight, I believe in God's promises. Just like Abraham, he believed that him and the lad would return. And he went not knowing where he was going, but he had the faith to believe and trust in God. When I believe the gospel, just like you brothers and sisters, when I believe that God would grant unto me a forgiveness of my sins when I repented, I believe with all my heart that God would cleanse me from all of my sins. I believe, and I've still got faith to believe tonight, that he said, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you. If there's any leaving tonight, it'll be me leaving the Lord. It won't be the Lord leaving me. It'll be me leaving the Lord. If I be faithful unto death, there's a crown of life that the righteous judge will give to us in that day. God's promises are true. Brother Tommy, the faith that we've got, and we walk by this faith every day of our life, I'm looking if it would be the last day on this earth, listen, that we would meet the Lord in the air somewhere out there. That's a
Texas sure promised. Brother, that one of these days when it comes time that God will judge this world in righteousness by that man whom he has ordained to be the judge of the quick and the dead, and he is appearing, there's coming a time that the saints of God and the dead in Christ are going to get up out of the grave. I believe what God tells me. I believe exactly what God is telling me is true. If I didn't have faith in it, I wouldn't be here tonight. God told me that His promises are true, and He's a God that cannot lie. He is truth. But there's coming a time when He calls, the Bible says that all the dead is going, that's in the grave will hear His voice, and they're going to come forth. Them that have done good under the resurrection of everlasting life.
There's no end to that, are there?
Them that have done good under the resurrection of everlasting life, and them that have done evil under the resurrection of everlasting contempt and shame. No end to that either. Eternal life is eternal. Eternal damnation and punishment is eternal. And if you live in sin, the wages of sin is eternal death. But if you live in righteousness through His Spirit, it'll be eternal life. There's the choice we've got. That's the promise we've got. Knowing the terror of the Lord, knowing the wrath of God that's going to come one of these days, we persuade men. We want to persuade men and women to come to repentance, that they may have their sins forgiven, washed and cleansed and justified, sanctified, set apart from this world. Live. Now, how are we going to live? Just any way? Paul said, talking to the church, I beseech thee therefore, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. There's some works. Holy. There's some works. They're holy works. They're righteous works. Present your body a living sacrifice. Holy. And acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world. The church is not conformed to this world. We don't have no part of this world. That's what's going on in the White House and all the high ups tonight. We're wondering what's going on with them, why they're doing. You know the Bible says the world loves its own.
Yes, sir. Amen.
The world loves its own. That's why they're not obeying the commandments of God. They're carnal-minded. They're doing to please the flesh. They're not doing to please God or the world or of the church, but they're doing to please the world, the majority of this world. And listen, my friends, the commandments of God is true to us tonight that believe. Don't be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of our minds. We need our minds renewed. That we may prove, or we have proven unto this world tonight, whose side we're on, whose servant we are. That we may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We should be approving what's the good will of God, the perfect will of God. Don't be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. We mentioned last night some of the works of the flesh. That is of the flesh, all them that are all the flesh, they mind the things of the flesh. the things of the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
That's where we're sanctified. We're set apart. We're not all this world. Brother Tony, and I'll tell you one thing else too. The kingdom of God is not all this world either. He said if my kingdom was all this world, men would fight, wouldn't it? Boy, that'd be something for the old Baptist people, wouldn't it? Trying to get ahead of each other. All this here belongs to God.
Yes, sir.
This church, this kingdom belongs to God.
Yes,
and He's ahead of Christ is ahead of His church.
Yes,
we're just members of it. I may be just a little finger, but I'm still just a little member. I can't lord over God's inheritance now. He's the one that's in charge of all of it. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God? For the indwelling, I thought of that song. He lives inside of men's hearts and life. And know ye not that ye are the temple of God, for the indwelling of His Spirit? Our bodies ought to be alike. It ought to be a clean life. That the world may see our good works and glorify the Father, which is in heaven tonight. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. By faith, Abraham moved and won God's promises, and it was imputed for him as righteousness. And that's the way it is with us today. Brother Tommy, if we move by faith and keep the commandments of God, when it comes down to the judgment of God, we'll be counted as righteous. Amen. When we come down time to die, according to the Word of God, if we go down filthy, we're going to get up filthy.
Right. Yep.
And if we go down righteous, we're going to get up righteous. So that's why we need to put works with our faith. And God has commanded you tonight, my friend. He's commanding me everywhere to repent of your sins.
Right.
What works with that? Go to God and beg His forgiveness, repenting of your sins, and believing in Him and having faith to believe that He will save you from your sins. That you don't have to go into that lake. You don't have to go into that awful place. There is a lake of fire. My friends, that God has prepared for the devil and his angels and all nations that forget God. Maybe the United States. It may be the rest of them. But all nations that forget God will be turned into hell. They'll go into that lake of fire. Now listen, my friend, there's going to be probably multitude thousands that will stand in that day and say, Lord, Lord, haven't we done many wonderful works in Your name? Haven't we cast out devils in Your name? And He's going to say, depart from me. Ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. Let's have a good and honest heart. Let's have a good and honest heart. The pure in heart is going to see God. You know that? The pure in heart shall see God. I think every eye is going to look up on Him that they crucified. But I like you, my brother. I like what the Lord said. I like what God said. God has highly exalted His Son, Jesus Christ, and given Him a name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow and every tongue should confess to the glory of the Father. Now, whosoever will hear these sayings of mine There's your faith, and there's your works. Whosoever will hear these sayings of mine and doeth them, Brother Tommy, he said, I will show you what he's likened unto. This comes down to me and you. Whosoever will hear these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will show you what he's likened unto. He is likened unto a man that dug deep and built his house upon a solid foundation. Talk about getting serious with God. You talk about getting serious, escaping that wrath of God, and getting serious about making heaven your home. You get serious, you dig deep, and you get upon the solid rock. You get upon, you build upon the truth of God. I will show you what he's likened unto. He's likened unto a wise man that dug deep and built his house upon a solid rock. And when the storms came and the rains came and the winds blew and beat upon that house, he said the house fell not. You get in Christ, there ain't no storm can tear you down. If you'll trust him. If you're rooted and grounded and settled, my friend, you may be like an old white oak. You may toss back and forth. But I'm telling you, if you got the roots, you'll not come out of the ground. You be rooted and grounded and settled in Jesus Christ and have the faith and the confidence in him. Then listen, there ain't nothing tonight. No principalities, powers, no death, height, no angels or nothing that is able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus the Lord. My anchor holds. I don't know about yours. I don't know your mind. I don't know your heart. But I know my anchor holds. My anchor is Jesus. He's been tried. He went through the storms. He went through all the sufferings. He went through the death on the cross. My friend, listen, but still, he got up triumph over death, hell, and the grave. He got up over it all. And he said, all power is mine. All power is given unto me, both in heaven and on earth. I have power. Listen tonight. Because that I live, Jesus said, you can live also. Yeah. That's another promise. That's a promise that he promises. My friend, listen. I know for sure by the work of God, by the word of God, and by the faith that I've got in God, this old body of mine, it's a molder back to the dust. We'll take him a little nap. I don't know how long it'll be, but it won't be very long. But when I go to sleep, listen, I'll be waking. I ain't going to suffer in the grave.
No.
I ain't going to have to worry about how long I'm going to stay there. The skin worms may devour this body of mine, but I'm going to see the Lord. There's no knowledge in the grave. No knowledge, Brother Tommy. There's no knowledge in the grave. Blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor and their works to follow them. Trumpets going to sound. Them which sleep in God will cry. In Christ will God bring with him. They're going to come back. The souls of men are going to unite with the body, and they're going to get up with a glorified body.
Amen.
If I didn't have that promise tonight, if I didn't have that faith and the confidence in God, listen, my friends, the dead in Christ are going to raise first. If I'm here, they're going to get up before I'm changed. That's the first he's talking about. The dead in Christ is going to raise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be changed in a moment in the twinkling of an eye and be caught up together with them. Yeah, we're going to be caught up together with them that got up. Some of us have our prayer rejoicing, jumping, leaping, everything. This is when God changes that vile body of his like everyone else and fashion it like an unto his glorious body, they're going to get up and we'll be changed and be caught up together with them and to meet the Lord in the air and forever be with the Lord. It sounds like eternal, don't it? It sounds like eternal life. Wherefore, he wanted us to know this. He wanted us to have this assurance. Brother Tony, because he told us to comfort one another with these words. It's a comfort to me tonight to know that the dead in Christ is going to live again. And those which live in Christ are alive when he comes will be caught up. They'll be changed in a moment. We won't be changed from a sinner to a saint, but we'll be changed from a mortal and put on immortality. Changed from a natural body and put on a spiritual body. Sowing in weakness, raised in power. I've got to promise that I'll be able to look back the old grave and say, "Oh grave, where's your victory? Oh grave, where is your victory?" Death swallowed up in victory. Oh grave, where's your victory?
I was going to ask you what you thought about
my friend's death.
Getting lost.
He swallowed up in victory.
Makes my heart dumb.
Our victory tonight.
And I've got to go see
this me. Is a victory that overcometh this world, even our faith. Our faith. Let's keep the faith. That's what Paul said. I have kept the faith. If you want victory, put your trust in God. Put it in His Son, Jesus Christ. Call out on Him tonight. Seek Him while He may be found. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is nigh. And He said, if you knock, it shall be opened unto you. We'll leave you right where I found you, in the hands of a merciful God. And my friends tonight, listen, don't put it off. Don't put off salvation. Don't put it off. You can believe in the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, believe in Him and have faith in Him. You can go on your way home tonight, a brand new creature in Christ Jesus. Being born again, not of corruptible seed, but by an incorruptible, by the Word of God. You can be born again with the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. My friends tonight, I'm going to ask the singers to come, get them a song this time. I'd like Brother Tommy, I could preach another hour or two, probably. I feel a little better tonight than I have all week. But listen, I'm going to feel better one of these times. When the Lord changes His body, man, I'll feel better, Brother Tom. And I know you will too. So tonight, if you will hear His voice, harden not your heart. Don't harden your heart. Don't say, well, this or well, that. Just say, Lord, I'm trusting in You. I believe in You. And I'm going to do the best I know how to do. Come. Don't doubt God. Trust God. Take Him at His word. Listen, my friends. He will come in. Him and His Father, Jesus and His Father, will come in and take up their abode. They'll make their abode in your life. They'll go home with you. You can leave here and go on your way rejoicing. You can go out down here and be buried with Christ in baptism, raised to walk in a new life. Bury you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And raised to walk in a brand new life. Set your mind and your affections on the things above. And not on the things of this earth. They're going to sing you a song. Brother Tommy, come up here. Church doors are open. Church doors are open. The Lord opened them a long time ago. And the Spirit is saying, come. The bride, the church is saying, come. Jesus is saying, whosoever will, let him come and take of the water of life freely. Mm-hmm. or sing, the church doors open. If someone has repented, believed the gospel, and you're ready to take up fellowship with the old church, God adds you to the church. You come and tell us. You come and tell us. I'm ready. I'm ready. The Lord's forgive me. So while they sing,
when time runs out for you, and hope for life is through, the deadline you have drawn, God's mercy ever lost.
Let's have a good night,
fellowship. And lay